The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus went into the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciple, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" They replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter said in reply, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus said to him in reply, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my heavenly Father. And so I say to you, you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loose in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I'm sure that if we go to heaven, we will be surprised. Surprised in the sense that the one who were considered nothing, lowly, in this world could be among the great in heaven. Yung mga tinuturing na wala, maliliit, dito sa mundo, baka sila yung mga dakila sa kaharian ng Diyos. At yung mga tinuturing na champion of this world, either the little or no one in heaven. Why? Because the criteria of God is not the criteria of the world. My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, the persecuted because of their faith, the one who is silent in the way they serve, the one who considered themselves nothing, no one, or as Saint Ignatius of Loyola, who desired nothing, either good health or sickness, riches or poverty, who desired nothing except Jesus. That's why in the Vigil Mass yesterday, it is important that the criteria one who wants to follow the Lord must love the Lord in the way Peter was asked, "Do you love me?" 3 times he was asked, "Tend my sheep, tend my lamb, tend my sheep. Do you love me more than this?" What are those these? Do you love me because of the miracles you experience? Of the healing, perhaps? Of the adulation? Of the recognition? Do you love me more than this? It's one way of saying, do you love me more than what you receive? My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, if you want to go to heaven, God or Jesus said to the rich young man, you must love the Lord with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. The three loves. You must love the Lord with all your mind, with all your soul, with all your hearts. That's the primary criterion of someone who follow God. As I have said before, not all works in the church are works of God. Not all who serve in the church serve God. We have to accept this. Because there are people who love the service of the Lord, but not the Lord of the service. Take note, there are people who love the service of the Lord, the things that they do in the church, not the Lord of the service. Not all who preach about God love God. They love the preaching. You have to accept it. Kaya nga sabi ng Diyos, I do not know you. Lord, we accompany you. We dine with you. And God said, I do not know you. Because not all who do the things in the church, they are doing it for God. You want to be great, then start loving God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and we add with all your strength, if you still have the strength. Because someday, all of us will become sick and nothing will be left in us. Second, it is important that through the readings that those who will be great in heaven are not the sinless. Not the sinless. You know that Peter denied Jesus 3 times. You know that Saint Paul have murdered many followers of Christ. There are, if you look at the genealogy, there were prostitutes. There were adulterous people. But they will be among the great. For 2 simple reasons. They have repented. When we say repent, they have changed their lives. And they did the will of God. Hindi sapat na ikaw ay tumalikod sa pagkakasala. Kailangang mayroong pagbabagong buhay. At hindi sapat na mayroong pagbabagong buhay, mayroong pagsunod sa kalooban ng Diyos. Pagsunod sa kalooban ng Diyos, at ang una ay dahil sa pagmamahal sa Diyos. Again, my brothers and sisters, as I have said, if we go to heaven, that is the presumption. No one can presume that I will go to heaven. Remember this, no one is born of a woman greater than John the Baptist. No one born of a woman greater than John of the Baptist. And yet, Jesus said, John the Baptist is the least in the kingdom of heaven. Yun ang pamantayan. Yun ang panukutan. If you think you are greater than John the Baptist, then you are deceiving yourself. And yet, John the Baptist is the greatest in this world. And he is the least in the kingdom of heaven. One of the recollections we have in this chapel was given by Father Bennett Wasson, one of our mass presiders. And he said, a servant serve out of love for God. If you serve out of convenience, out of your free time, he said, you are not serving God, but you are only serving yourself. I guess that applies to everyone. If we only go to Mass out of convenience, out of our free time, then maybe we are not really in love with God, but love ourselves. My dear friends, we will not go to heaven by mere fulfilling the law. You have to understand it. We have to start by loving God with all our heart, with all our mind, with all our soul, and with all our strength. And second, we must turn away from sin and do the will of God. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you in your family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.